Good afternoon. Thank you, Hans and Kurt, for giving Agoria the opportunity to present our software tool today. Because of the lack of time, it is not possible to give a live demonstration of our tool, but I have prepared some slides and screenshots to demonstrate you our tool. First, a small word on the reason why Agoria has decided to develop a software tool. It is our experience that many companies struggle with the practical implementation of the GDPR. And to help the companies, we thought it would be a good idea to develop a self-assessment tool that companies can use to analyze the risks of their processing activities. So our GDPR compass contains an internal record, 165 yes or no questions. Each concept and principle is defined and explained, including examples, and the result is a report indicating the measures to be taken by the companies. The challenge of our tool is to determine when a processing operation presents a risk, or even better, when a risk is sufficiently low to be acceptable. So if the risk is considered very high, a data privacy impact assessment is needed, and our tool will indicate that. And in other cases, appropriate measures, also indicated by our tool, can remedy and manage the risk. So the tool is structured around 9 themes or blocks: preliminary questions, purposes, context, legal basis, parties involved in the processing, nature of data, transfer to third countries, information to be provided to the data subject or rights of the data subject, and security. So each theme or block consists of yes or no questions. Each question leads to the following question, so there is a kind of logic or flow in the tool. Some questions ask for a detailed analysis and contain sub-questions. And each question, where necessary, is explained through a comment in a pop-up window. I will show you that on the screenshot. So the user has all the information needed to answer the question. Of course, the most important thing of our tool, or part of our tool, is the output. And the output consists of two parts. First, an inventory of the questions and the answers given by the person who completed the tool. That gives an overview of the state of play. And secondly, a to-do list. So the actions or measures that have to be undertaken by the company to be compliant. The tool also gives some conclusions whether the processing is legal or not. For example, the tool indicates whether you can transfer your personal data to third countries or not. The output can be used as a part of the principle of accountability towards the supervisory authority to demonstrate compliance with the GDPR. Or at least the willingness to be compliant by indicating that your organization is taking the necessary steps or measures in order to be compliant. Of course, the tool can also be used in the internal control and audit process of your company. So now I have some screenshots of the tool. So here you see the name of the company. Here you have the frequently asked questions that explain how you have to use the tool. Here you see the language. The Dutch version of the tool is finished. In 2 weeks, normally, the French version will be finished, and then later on, we will concentrate on the English version of the tool. Here you see a general introduction to the GDPR. And then, before starting the questionnaire, you have to complete and download the internal register or the internal record. Keeping a record shall be an obligation also for the SMEs. The record also needs to be provided at request to the supervisory authority. Our internal register, where you see now just a part of it, works with the drop-down menu, so you can indicate what is applicable for your organization. Below you see that all the concepts like verwerkingsdoelen, de betrokkenen, persoonsgegevens are explained in the Excel file of the internal record. This is an example of a question. You see the E from information, so that is the tooltip, and this is, for example, the tooltip for that question. The tool also examines whether your processing operations are standard processing operations, like, for example, the administration of the workers. For standard processing operations, the questionnaire will be shorter because for those kinds of operations, normally they present a lower risk, so the questionnaire will be shorter. Each block of questions is also, there is also a comment that introduces every team of questions. This is another example of a question with a tooltip. And then, last but not least, the output of the tool, the most important part. This is just an extract of the final list. On the left you see the questions and you also see the answer the person has given to the question, and at the right you see the concrete measures that the companies have to take to be compliant with the GDPR. So for those people who want to have more information about our tool, they can visit our website mentioned on the slide, or they can contact us, of course. Thank you for your attention.